guys, it's Patricia and welcome to Tester Tuesday. Exciting news, we are going into the fall and winter scents. At the end of the video, we will be drawing for our first round and we will be warming some new scents for next week. Well, I should say me, but you guys get to pick and that's what I like to hear about. So let's talk about last week's voting. If you're new to my channel, basically what I do is I warm testers, see what they're like, tell you guys. And you guys tell me which ones to warm the following week by voting. So we had 186 votes, and in first place, we had this maroon-colored wax. I don't happen to have a bar, but I have a brick. And it's the scent of Welcome Home. Now, these bricks are available through Scentsy Club. And actually, just as a side note, some of my customers' bricks are on back order, so I wanted to call Scentsy, but I reached out to my director, and she informed me that some of the clamshells are short. So that is just something to know. So anyway, Welcome Home had 26% of the vote. And in second place, a beautiful light green colored wax. With 20% of the vote, we have Aloe, Water, and Cucumber. So let's talk about our first place scent this week. It's the beautiful maroon colored wax of Welcome Home. And on cold sniff, I definitely get a lot of real estate to smell with these bricks. I would say it's about a medium intensity. This scent you can purchase year round in bar form. And it's in the spice category, and into the fall and winter catalog, it's a top seller. So the scent description for Welcome Home, it is warm and welcoming with cinnamon and spices. So it's a little bit vague. I would definitely say it is warm and it is welcoming. It is very much a quintessential fall scent to me, but you could warm this all year round if you're a spice lover, and I think the fact that it sells well is why they keep it all year round. So I would say for cinnamon, it's not really bakery, it's not really red hot, it's in the middle, it's that potpourri, primitive style cinnamon. And I would say there's other spices, maybe like nutmeg, maybe allspice. A lot of nutmeg, I think, but mainly a very nice blending of all the spices that are in here. Like, it's very soft, but pleasant. When I say soft, I don't mean that you can't smell the cinnamon, but what I mean is everything kind of blends well together and it's very appealing. I would say there's some sweetness in here in the form of something like maybe a fig or definitely brown sugar, I would say. I'm wondering, as I warm the scent, I pick up something and I'll tell you what I pick up. But my previous experience with Welcome Home was that I liked it, it just wasn't very strong for me. So I wanted to see how it would do this time around because I thought it was just a partial bar that I finished off a while ago, probably like a couple of years ago. So it was hard to remember. So I had some, I'm dropping stuff over here. I had four big testers and two small. And I decided to put some in my open layout. The strength and throw was about 6 out of 10 max. It did struggle a little bit there. It might have even been a little bit less than that. And I left it going just one day, 15 hours. And sometimes I would go up to the warmer and I could smell the wax, but it wasn't like permeating through the air. So I decided to take the one party tester I had left over, and which is about a cube, and I put it in my entranceway, which is kind of like our laundry room, our side entrance. And that one, it's still going. I have it going, it's about 50 hours. Now, I would say the first half of that was about a good solid 6.5. And then now it's pretty low. I keep thinking I can't smell it and maybe I should take it out. And last night I said, I'm just gonna let it go overnight and I'll take it out in the morning. And when I walked by this morning, I could smell it again. So it's one of those scents that I feel like I go nose blind to, but once I've had a break from it, I can smell it again. So just something to know. And I would say if you're someone that likes scents, I think this reminds me of, I think it's called Home Sweet Home by Yankee, kind of along that style. And if you've smelled the scent, I think it's called My Home from Scentsy. It's like this, that scent, but it has a little floral note. So both of those are kind of ones that you can draw from to compare. I would say this is sweeter than something like an Autumn Sunset. Autumn Sunset is aggressive cinnamon, aggressive craft store, and this is more of a sweeter craft store. And the only thing I noticed as I warmed it, I felt like I could get a little bit of a like a tobacco leaf smell. And sometimes you're thinking, like, I don't want to smell cigarettes. It doesn't smell like cigarettes. It smells like that sweet tobacco scent. Sometimes I get that as the scent warms. But if I were gonna warm this myself, in my home, I would stick to medium zones. So my bonus room, which is kind of like our rec room, maybe if I wanted something like this in my bedroom or in my entranceway, I think it would do okay in my downstairs son's room as well. because his room tends to do well with most scents. But I don't think I'll be warming this in my open layout anymore. But what can I mix with Welcome Home, you're asking? Well, I Googled. Because believe it or not, I actually don't do a lot of mixes. I'm usually warming everything to give feedback to you guys, so I really don't have a lot of time to mix. But I Googled, and some of the scents that were suggested were Rum Raisin Cookie, Simply Vanilla, Butter Pecan, Everything Nice, Johnny Appleseed. And if you're wanting to know what I do to find out some mixes, sometimes I just come up with them in my head without trying. But you can always Google mixes with Welcome Home Scentsy, and that will give you some ideas. Will I repurchase this scent? I mean, I don't need to. I have a whole brick. But after the brick is done, I probably like to have a bar on hand just for the times that I'm craving it. Yeah, it's really pleasant, and it might be one of those ones that as I warm the whole brick, I might get tired of it, but right now it's really pleasant. It's just not overly strong for me, and it's fairly long-lasting in a smaller to medium zone, so that is Welcome Home. All right, the next scent we are going to talk about is Aloe Water and Cucumber. There we go. This one on Cold Sniff is about a medium as well, and this is in the current catalog. It's available year-round, and it's in the fresh category, and it is a top seller. So this one came out, I believe, in the spring and summer of 2018. And I will read you the scent description. It says, aloe water, cucumber peel, palm frond, and pineapple nectar are oh so mellow. So all those scents kind of put together, it reminds me of a very spa light green scent. Light in nature, not like something very aggressive green. So a softened green. Aloe is a nice, soft, gentle scent. Cucumber peel has a nice fresh scent to it. Yes, palm frond is like the leaves of a palm or a fern. So maybe you can get that in here. And pineapple, I don't really get at the beginning, but as I warm it, sometimes I feel like I pick it up. But like I said, very spa-like, very soothing, sweet, pleasant. My first experience with this, I will tell you, I warmed a tester here in my bedroom probably about 2 years ago. And I was down in my kitchen and the door was open about 6 inches and I'm sitting at my kitchen island, which is probably, I don't even know how many feet away. It's far away. And I'm like, what's that smell? It was the aloe water and cucumber, and it was coming from this bedroom. So this one has the oh so mellow in the scent description, but it's not mellow. It is a great thrower. So where did I put my two testers? Now, I did recently finish a bar, so I can definitely kind of give you a little bit more feedback. But in one area, I put this was my entranceway, just like I have Welcome Home finishing up now. Strength of throw, 9 out of 10. And I left it going 3 days, 46 hours. I have a note here. The last 12 to 18 hours were pretty light, but I kind of left it in. I think it's because sometimes you could still kind of smell it. And I hate removing wax if it's still doing its job. And with the other tester, I put it in my son's room in his new Spider-Man warmer. Strength and throw there was a little bit lower, and that room is kind of warm lately, so I don't know. But 8 out of 10, still very respectable. I left it going 3 days, 10 hours a time for 30 hours. I did forget to check towards the end. Now, I think towards the end, that's when I kind of picked up some pineapple nectar, or what I think is pineapple nectar. But yeah, this is a good scent. If you like clean spa-like scents, if you like food or gentle fruit-like scents with some greenery, I think you would like this. It's not the same, but it's kind of in that family of, like, say, white tea and cactus. And to me, it's more of a twist on, like, the old 80s, like, cucumber melon. There's no melon, there's pineapple, but it's kind of along that vibe. This would be great for, I wrote down a few spots, open concept, bathroom, laundry room, bedroom. And then I just stopped and wrote anywhere, because really this is a good performer. And I also Googled some mixes with this, so I'm just going to read some off to you in case you are looking for some ideas. And no, I have not tried any of these mixes. Watermelon Wave, which is no longer available. Let's Get Punchy. Lucky Starfruit Coming in the International Collection. White Grapefruit, Summer Sunshine, Sea Salt and Avocado, Mandarin Splash. So some of those scents are no longer available, but that'll just give you some ideas. Now, one excellent way to mix something, it's just a piece of advice from me to you, is if you pick up the pods in aloe water and cucumber and you have lots of other pods, you can put the pods in and within 5 minutes you can tell if you like a scent mix or not. You would put one pod of this and one pod of your other scent, and if you don't like it, you just take them out of the wall fan diffuser and you haven't wasted any wax. So that is where I would suggest starting if you have lots of pots. Will I repurchase this scent? Yes. I always suggest you have a bestseller in your stash, because sometimes if you're a consultant, people will be looking for this. And sometimes it's just nice to have, because like I said, there's lots of mixing options. It's just a nice, good, solid performer. It's a bestseller for a reason, and that is aloe water and cucumber. Definitely a good one. All right, so we are going to draw for the scents this week. I have my brown bag. We have 10 new release scents for the Fall and Winter 2020 catalog, plus 5 new to the catalog scents that were mostly former scents of the month or one was in a collection. So if you're new to my channel, basically I'm going to draw 6 scents from this bag. You guys are still going to vote for 2 different scents by Wednesday morning. Check the pinned comment to see if voting is opened or closed. And if you cannot vote here on YouTube, you can alternately vote on my Instagram post. It's Patricia Gates. Look me up and put your votes there. Now, the only difference is I am going to be warming 3 scents each week, so it'll take us 5 weeks to finish up. So again, 2 votes each. You ready? First scent, Perfect Pumpkin Pear. Scent number 2, an orange wax, Autumn Road Trip. Scent number 3, Caramel Apple Craze. Scent number 4, Cloudberry Dreams. Scent number 5, Almond Croissant. And scent number 6, Slay All Day. So we have a mix of new releases and returning. So we have Perfect Pumpkin Pear, a October scent of the month, 2019. Autumn Road Trip, a new release. Caramel Apple Craze, a September 2019 scent of the month, that's new to the catalog. Cloudberry Dreams, a new release. Almond Croissant, a new release. And Slay All Day, a new release. So thanks for spending the last few minutes with me. Don't forget to vote, and I will see you guys in the next video.